If we take the example of iron planets, they are expected to form near a star, because presumably this is where the protoplanetary disk consists of a lot of iron-rich material. Why iron and not another metal? It is because iron is a rather abundant element in the universe, the sixth most abundant. By mass, the one element you are most likely to find in the universe, and by far, is hydrogen, the simplest kind of atom. It is followed by helium. When hydrogen nuclei merge in stars during thermonuclear fusion, it produces helium. So it is another abundant element that stars keep producing all the time. In third place, there is oxygen, followed by carbon and neon. We rarely hear about neon because it is quite rare on Earth. There are traces of it in the atmosphere, where it is a gas, and there is even less in the Earth's crust. There is little neon on rocky planets because it is highly volatile and it forms no compounds that could fix it to solids like oxygen does. So it tends to escape from planets in the early stages of their formation. It doesn't stay trapped in the condensing clouds of gas and dust that form solid planets like Earth. But it is a more significant component of larger gas planets and stars. And in sixth position comes iron, far above any other metal. So this is a typology of planets by composition. But there are other ways of categorizing planets. For example, by mass. The term super-Earth has been coined to name a type of exoplanet that is more massive than Earth, but still less than the giants of the solar system. Theoretically, a rocky super-Earth could be habitable, but gravity could be much higher than we are used to. Another concept based on mass is super-Jupiter, a planet that is more massive than Jupiter. Various of them have been discovered, including OTS-44, we are on our way to visit. And yet another way to categorize planets is by their orbit. This is where the concept of hot Jupiter or hot Neptune appears. These would be gas giants or ice giants, orbiting much closer to their star than they do in the solar system. And they're called hot because the proximity of their sun would mean high temperatures in their more superficial layers.